Hey Lollipops, welcome back to my YouTube channel, you guys. On today's episode, I am going to be telling you some things that I hate about being a mom. You guys, sometimes it's not all bed of roses. There are some times that you feel like you're struggling too much. You need to relax, you need to breathe, you need to be alone, you need to just be by yourself so you can survive. You guys, I'm sure that every mother feels this at some point, okay? There are some situations that choke me. Like when I see these things, I'll be like, oh girl, you choke, really, you choke. So you guys, I want to ask all mothers out there, have you ever been in a situation where you tell yourself like, why did you go ahead to do this? Well, who sent you? Like that kind of vibe. Have you ever been in that situation? If you have been, drop your experience and your comments on the comment section, or in the comment section, whichever one. English is English and it must be spoken, period. Guys, without any further ado, let's dive into it. So on today's episode, I am going to be sharing some few things that I hate about being a mom. It's not a bad feeling, it's not anything bad, it's normal, okay? There are some days that you need to rest, and these children, they are all over you, and you'll be like, oh, I wish I was not a mom so I could just relax for these few days or these few times, okay? So it's natural, it happens. You're not the devil, trust me, you're not. Number one on the list today is, I hate being a mom the days that I'm sick. Yes, because nobody is going to understand that mommy needs to be alone and heal up and be better and feel good for us again. Everybody's literally disturbing because my children are actually very young. My first is going to be 8 very soon, 8 years, I mean to say. So they are still very much dependent on me, and when I am sick, I just tell them, they understand, they care for me, okay? They try to do the little things they can do for me, like bring water for me, help me cover my leg when I'm covering up with a wrapper or anything. And they help me do what they can do. But then I have to cook if there is no food. I have to still take care of them as a mom, even while I am sick. And those days, I feel like, who sent me? Who tell me make I go born? I see people when they born, I carry body, put body, so I won't born my own. If I don't say that like this, they are for no born. So sometimes I feel that way, okay? But it's natural. I feel better afterwards and I feel loved, okay? But when I'm sick, it's very frustrating to take care of children because they're not going to understand. Sometimes you're just too weak. You just want to rest, be in your room, in your bed, sleeping. But then they keep knocking, calling out for you. Mommy, we need bread. We need food. We need to eat. I'm hungry. Mommy, is this person just food? In your sick bed, you'll be like, God, why? So guys, one thing that I hate again about being a mom is when there is no food in the house. I mean cooked food. Yes, it can be very, very annoying, trust me when I say that. Look, when there is no food there, the pressure is getting worse. Like, these children don't understand when you say there is no food, just eat this, or just eat this bread, or eat that. Before you know, they're asking for something. All right, so that is why I love to make my food in box, so I don't run out of meals at home. Because you go there outside, somebody's telling you, mommy, it's only bread you give us. That kind of vibe. When you have food, you're going out, you can just simply carry your food in a flask or a cooler and outside with you. So I hate to be a mom days that food are not in the house, or we don't have cooked food in the house. It makes me so sad because those children, they don't understand English on those days. So guys, the next one is, I hate being a mom the days that my children are not feeling well. Oh my heavens, those days tend to be the worst days of my life, because especially younger children that are below 3 years, that can't even tell you what exactly they are going through. At least a child of 4 years can simply tell you that their head aches, or they are feeling stomach pain and aches and all of that. But a child that is below 3 years cannot say jack. They'll just be feeling uncomfortable, crying up and down, making you, the mother, feel very uncomfortable. I literally hate being a mom when my children are sick. I don't want to think about it because it's very horrible. Sincerely speaking, like, the last time my last baby was not feeling too well, gosh, I almost ran crazy. And that was the time that we were having this July challenge. I was traumatized at that time because I literally had to carry her. She was teething at the same time, having malaria. Okay, so it was just a roller coaster for me. I wasn't vibing. I hate it when my children are sick. It's very frustrating. You are not comfortable. They are not eating. You can't eat because your children are not eating, literally. And throwing up here and there, now and then, you know, before you know, you are feeding the person maybe probably two spoons and they puke and you're all over the place. Ugh. I hate being a mom when my children are sick. They shouldn't fall sick for me, please. So guys, the next one I hate about being a mom is cooking all the time. You guys, I love to cook. If you have come to my house, you should know that I love to cook in bulk. Okay, I'm not afraid of cooking. But you guys, I'm human. Sometimes I just want to rest and don't do anything. And those are the days that you literally have to cook. Mm-hmm. Those days that you say, oh, okay, on Saturday I just have to rest. But before Saturday more, your children have consumed all your meals and you'll be like, really? Really? So I have to cook this Saturday again? You don't have any choice. So you guys, I literally hate to cook on the days I want to rest. I don't have any choice, so I just have to carry my bag and go to the market. It is what it is. After all, I'm missing myself, Abby. So one of the things I hate actually about being a mom is having to cook a whole lot. Trust me, if you make a whole lot of pot of soup in your house, it doesn't last long. It doesn't even last you up to 1 month. These children, as they are growing, their stomach is actually growing bigger, so they eat a whole lot. I'm trying my best also as a mom not to overfeed them, but then they are growing children, so they need all the food and nutrients that they need to grow very healthy into a grown adult. So you guys, that's one of the things that also that I hate about being a mom. Yeah, it is what it is. And sometimes I hate it. So lollipops, last on the list is, I hate being a mom because I need to always wake up on time. God. When I did not have these children, I was sleeping as I like. I was a sleephead. You guys, I can't sleep for Africa. Like, you see, the early morning from that kind 5:30 a.m. stroke to 9, sleep in those period can be very sweet. Trust me, no matter how bad your sleep is, once it's that early morning, 4:30 ahead of time, like to 9, see, no matter what it be, you must sleep. And that is the exact time that you need to wake up. Else, your children are going to keep going to school late. You guys. I hate it. Like, it makes me uncomfortable. Like, I don't vibe at all. Like, I feel very uncomfortable those days. Like, thank God for holiday. At least we have to sleep till 8 a.m. Because once it's 7 something, the children already are awake. And they are knocking on your room door. They need to eat. They need to brush. They need to have their bath. So yeah, so waking very early in the morning is one of those things I hate about being a mom, you guys. It's not funny. Just imagine when I had a new baby, I had to literally still wake up that early though. It is what it is. So lollipops, those are the few things that I hate about being a mom. If there's anything that comes on my mind anyways later, then I will have to do a part two. Or maybe I would organize a talk show with a mom to ask her what she hates about being a mom, you guys. So until next time, my lollipops, stay safe and play big. Good night.